Now we come to the portion of our program where we learn about somebody's particular bridge to faith. How did they come to faith? And let's find out. Let's ask them right now.
My name is Pierre Vogel in the passport, also called Abu Hamza or Salahuddin. I was born in 1978. When I was very young, I had always friends from Muslim countries, like from Morocco or from Turkey. And I had always contact with them, but unfortunately they were not practicing too much. But I had always sympathy with these people because they were my friends. Later on, I was a Protestant, but I went to a Catholic school, and this Catholic school, it's quite strict. For example, in my time when I was there, it was not allowed for women to go to, or for girls to go to the school. The boys are alone in the school, and so I learned a bit about Christianity. And when I was 14 years old, as a Protestant, I went to church and had some discussions because I was always interested in Christianity and in the existence of God and this thing. And then I was discussing with a Christian priest and about some things they seemed to me like contradictions in the Bible. And he admitted that there are contradictions in the Bible. And so when I was 14 years old, I lost the faith in this religion. And later on, I became like an atheist or also agnostic. I didn't know really, is there a God, is there not a God? I was in great doubt if there is a God, a creator. Because I thought for myself, if there is a creator, we have to have a perfect message from him. He has to create us for a reason, for a purpose. And if there is no book that is correct, in totality from the beginning to the end, so it's a sign that there's no creator, because how come the creator creates us and he does not tell us what to do? So I thought, yeah, I live for this life, and you have to have party and all these things. And then later on, when I was around 20 years old, after my 21 years old, I went to a civilian service. In Germany, you have to choose after school, the men have to choose between a military service or civilian service. And in this civilian service, I went to the Red Cross organization, and I helped old people. I bring them always the food, and when I bring them the food, I saw that these people are living very lonely. And in Germany, all 47 minutes there's a suicide in Germany. This is the official number. And a lot of these old people, you come to them and you every day you go to their houses and you give them something to eat, and they say, no, stay a bit, we want to talk to you, and we're so lonely. So I was thinking about the purpose of life, and every week, or not every week, but a lot of them died in this time. So I was thinking about the hereafter, I was thinking about the purpose of life, and I began to read about religions. First, I wanted to know about Buddhism, because the image of Buddhism is very nice in Germany. The Dalai Lama, he has a smile for everybody and so on. And so I read about it, but for me, it gave not, in my own impression, it gave not too much sense. I even loved Christianity more than this, because I don't really care about the God or creator or a higher being. Then in this civilian service, we had to go for 1 week to a special camp. And in this camp, I met a guy from a German party, German political Christian party, not the big Christian party, but a small one. And this guy was talking about Islam, was talking very bad about Islam, and that he's in a Christian party. And I asked him, what is your aim in your party? So he told me, our aim is to destroy Islam in Germany. To destroy Islam in Germany, Islam is a bad religion, they cut off the hand, and the women are all oppressed, and they build mosques here, and there is an adhan, and it's not from the German culture. Yeah, silly reasons actually, and I tried to defend Islam, Because a week before, I think almost a week before, I went to the streets in Germany and somebody gave me a paper, a Muslim, inviting to Islam. And there were some points that I liked at the very beginning. Like that he told us in this paper that the Islam says that it's not a new religion, but it's a religion of Adam, and that all the prophets came with the same religion, to submit, to surrender to Almighty God in sincerity. And this is something I liked. I said, SubhanAllah, I didn't say SubhanAllah, but I thought, this makes sense. It makes sense, you know, because how come there is one God and there are so many religions, but the Islam gives an explanation. Allah says in Surah Al-Nahl, chapter 16, verse 36, وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولٍ أَنْ يُعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَاجْتَنِبُوا الطَّاغُوتَ. We gave to ever, like in the translation, almost translation, we gave to every nation a messenger that he teach the people that they worship only the one God, Allah, the Almighty God, and that they don't worship the false gods, the Tahut. And then the Islam gave this paper gave also the reason why there are so many religions, that actually the messengers came with the same message, but the people